Baltic One is one of the biggest offshore wind farms being developed in Poland with a capacity of up to 1,560 megawatts. It will deliver clean energy to around 2 million Polish households. The project is developed by Equinor and Polenergia in a joint venture. It is located about 80 kilometers north from the port of Weber in water depths of 25 to 35 meters. The first comprehensive environmental survey campaign is already being executed by our contractor, the Polish company Mewo. The campaign has been going on for 1 year now and have involved numerous vessels and airplane surveys. The objective for the campaign is to collect data on the marine ecosystem, and the plan is to finalize the offshore surveys in May. The floating LiDAR campaign is an important step to collect data to develop our project. The LiDAR will collect metocean data, such as wave data and wind speed, for 12 to 24 months. And with all this information, engineers will be well equipped to design the wind turbine setup and foundations and do simulations needed to optimize and plan the execution of the project.
RPS LiDAR 4.5 buoy measures wind up to 300 meters in the air using a ZX LiDAR. It's very powerful and very good LiDAR. It also has other abilities as well. It can measure waves, it measures air temperature, barometric pressure. With this project, we're also measuring currents, tides, salinity, and oxygen levels as well in the water. We will connect all the buoy up, we'll charge it up, we will make sure it's transmitting. We have multiple ways of communicating to this buoy. It's got Iridium broadband, it's got Rudux protocol modems, it's Wi-Fi, 4G. So we have to make sure all this is working before it goes into water.
Pomimo tego, że te dane są automatycznie wysyłane drogą satelitarną bezpośrednio do centrum obróbki danych, ale mimo wszystko surowe dane najczęściej podpływa się statkiem i zgrywa z tych urządzeń pomiarowych, które są zainstalowane na tej pławie. Dzisiaj Equinor zdecydował się uzupełnić te badania właśnie o badania wieczności, takie szczegółowe. One są niezbędne do tego, żeby na przykład znaleźć finansowanie na inwestycje, żeby można było określić produktywność, czyli tak naprawdę określić, ile ta farma wiatrowa będzie przynosiła zysku inwestorowi.